Speaking of TG, let's talk about Ian, Big Mike, and my friends and family and friends. The first and foremost word that comes to mind is comedian. He was always able to brighten the mood with a funny comment or some hilarious anecdote. Dedicated is another word. He was a dedicated husband, father, papa, brother, uncle, and friend. My father touched the lives of anyone that he ran into. He was able to make lasting positive impressions in short periods of time. He became a neighborhood mayor by simply walking the dogs around the block daily. Everyone knew him and enjoyed his company and conversation. A great example of this is on our plane ride to Vegas when Carrie and I was getting married. He had to sit apart from Carrie, myself, and my mother. He was up front. And by the time we ended up landing and got in the hotel, we had random people coming up saying, "Hey, Mike," and saying, "Congrats, Carrie, Nick," and I just had that way about it. My father, as Father Stan mentioned, was an avid sports fan, loved his Eagles, Yankees, Maryland, and Rutgers college teams, just to name a few. Most importantly, he was a dedicated fan of his children. No matter how busy things got with work at OMB, he always found the time to make it to my hundreds of games over the years, whether it be baseball, soccer, or basketball. And likewise, he always attended Renee's dance and piano recitals. So I think he preferred my sporting. Some of my fondest memories of my father is baseball catches in the yard when he got home from work, playing horse in the driveway, tossing the football around, going to games, Phillies, Yankees, Rutgers games. He also loved animals as much as he loved his kids. He's up there with all his animals right now. Perhaps most of all, my dad was a provider. My sister and I rarely wanted anything. Dad worked incredibly hard day in and day out, always giving 100% of himself to what he was doing. He took immense pride in everything he did and owned. This is why he rose up his career at the state to assistant budget director, which is the highest non-political position available to him. His co-workers raved about how he was easy to talk to, get along with, and dedicate to the job. And this is the same commitment he brought to his family. Growing up, I didn't realize what a wonderful father I had, and I took it for granted. I just didn't think he was cool enough or whatever. But now looking back, I can see the father he was, and the way he was with his grandchildren. The love and joy and adoration he had for his four grandchildren was unparalleled. Once they entered his life, his entire focus became being the very best pop-pop one could be. I recall the excitement he had arriving home from work, asking Carrie if she wanted to go out, just so he could spend time alone with Ashley at the time. And when you bring grandkids to the car to listen to the Beatles, Elvis, Beach Boys. And he always made all the grandkids' games and events, just as he did for Renee. I always remember my dad's life at the party. He never needed to drink or smoke, do any drugs. He was just high on life. We will never forget how he could lead the singing and the holidays and dance without a care in the world as if nobody was watching. I'm certain that right now you are entertaining all the angels in heaven with your singing and dancing, and how lucky they are to have you. One of a kind. What my dad has. Thank you for everything you did for all of us, Dad. You will live in our hearts and minds forever. And I long for the day when